Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
SNL alum, I've always wanted to tell you one of the funniest SNL sketches of all time, Hedley and Wyche. Hedley and Wyche, the British toothpaste. Scott, do you remember this?
I barely remember.
This was
during a time when just like there wasn't a bad player on the show. You still had Adam Sandler was on the show. You had David Spade on the show. There was you. There was Chris Farley was on there. It was a toothpaste that was made with 3 tablespoons of sugar per tube. And all of you just had the most wrecked up, rotten ash British teeth.
Here, Kevin, let's revisit it.
My
favorite skit that you did was the subliminal guy.
Yeah, the subliminal guy was fun.
That was awesome.
Total, man.
Now, does it amaze you that, because obviously you live your life and your life has continual forward momentum and you're, you know, like this, things go in the past and they're gone and they're in the past forever. But you are Kevin Nealon, so you walk through this life and you encounter people like Justin and Josh and myself. And certain things for them stand out. Does that amaze you or get
you
annoy
have that
you
impact?
Sometimes? Or do you still like love it? I mean, you didn't even remember that bit.
No, I don't. Sometimes I'll watch a rerun of SNL. I'll see me in a sketch. I'll go, "What? I don't remember this one. What happens in this?"
But for somebody out there like Justin, that might have been the funniest thing you've ever
done. Yeah. Everybody has their favorites, you know? A lot of people aren't even familiar with me on SNL because it was so long ago. You know, I got out of there in 95 and they're more like Weeds fans, you know?
Well, yeah, I'm thinking like the millennials.
Yeah.
Probably, you know, your early 20s, late teens probably don't remember. They don't remember what happened 48 hours ago.
That's true. But for an SNL fan,
I mean, you had one of the great stretches of Weekend Update, 9 seasons, almost a decade on there. And I've always heard that the SNL cast members' days and weeks even are some of the most brutal jobs in entertainment, that you basically you sleep, eat when you can, and then you're at 30 Rock doing the show. What was a day like?
Yeah, it's all encompassing. You know, you're basically, you live your life at 30 Rock. You know, you're there on Monday. Monday morning, you know, you're home for a while. Then you go in to meet the host on Monday. And you all sit around Lorne Michaels' office, the producer, and you pitch your ideas to the host. And then Tuesday, you're supposed to be writing your sketches. Even if you're a cast member, you write. And then, on Wednesday, they start rehearsing the sketches. They start blocking them. Thursday, Friday, you know, the musicians come in, the band, and they rehearse. And then Saturday, you do a dress rehearsal, and then the live show.
And I know there's been all kinds of great hosts over the year. You had your Christopher Walken, Justin Timberlake are in people's minds as far as people that have just killed it every time they've been on. But then on the other end of that spectrum, you had people that you heard behind-the-scenes stories about, Paris Hilton, who showed up for like 2 hours during the week. It was obvious during the show itself how horrible of a job she did as far as practicing to get ready for
her
bits.
Did she host the show?
She did. It was a train wreck because she just never showed up for it. Did you ever have anybody that you worked with that was one of the guest hosts that you're like, this is not going to work? This is so bad, no matter how hard we try.
Well, the thing about the guest hosts is when they come on, they're really scared.
Yeah.
So they're your best friend. You know,
they're trying their hardest.
Yeah. And a lot of them, though, aren't used to live performances. You know, a lot of them are just like, they do movies and they're not used to a live audience, you know. And then others are like Broadway actors or whatever. You know, they've done a lot of theater, so they're used to it. So,
In particular ever stand out as far as like, man, either they didn't put in the work the same way you guys did, they didn't put in the effort, they didn't take it as seriously as they needed to, or they didn't gel with the cast?
Everybody says who was the worst host, and I can't think of anybody. A lot of people say Steven Seagal, but I didn't have a problem with
him. I don't even remember that.
Yeah.
Steven Seagal?
Yeah.
God, I got to look that up.
I've had some favorite ones, though. You know,
yeah, who was your favorite person to work with?
Bill Murray was great, you know, because he was from the original cast.
Yeah, I was going to say, that guy.
And then some unexpected people that you never thought would be funny, like William Shatner at the time. He had never done comedy before that on TV that I know of.
This was before he became a parody of himself.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
William Shatner, Robert Wagner was funny. We even had Robert Mitchum on there when I was there. That's how long ago it was.
That was a ways back.
Yeah, he was great.
Well, it's like you said, but now you have Weeds. So what is the makeup of, when you go out to the Comedy Factory this weekend? I mean, you've obviously got a whole new set of fans, and then you've got, guys like us that love you for everything you've done all the way through. So it's got to be fantastic having that.
It's a nice kind of eclectic mix of audience members. There's older people, there's younger people. And you know, when Weeds first came on, I would kind of do a gauge. The audience says, "How many people you guys see Weeds?" And you get a smattering of applause.
Right, yeah.
And then each year it got more and more and more until now it's, you know, a lot.
It was one of those shows that did really start to grow and develop. I want to ask you in a little bit how you got involved with that. The stand up, everything. We got to cut real quick. We're gonna do some sports. And
that got awkward. Justin Scott and Spiegel on 98 Rock. 98Online.com.